Hi, my name is Hannah. I've just finished my second year studying geography at Jesus College. So basically in this video, I'm going to be explaining what geography is and what it's like studying geography at university. If you'd already been thinking of studying geography, you might have heard a lot of people making jokes about it being maybe a colouring in degree or that you definitely want to become a geography teacher. I mean, when I was researching into doing geography at Oxford, I even saw a lot of headlines saying things like geography is just kind of a soft option for dumb and poor students. And while obviously these were kind of just jokes, I think it does put out kind of a false perception of the subject. So my aim with this video is basically to debunk some of these myths and to share my experience of what it's like so far studying geography. The first section I'm kind of going to address in this video is what actually is geography, and to do so I'm going to talk a little bit about kind of the history of the subject, because I think that helps explain what it has become today. So a lot of people kind of describe geography as a subject that looks at the relationship between people and places, and while I think this is true, I think geography is a lot broader than this, and especially just because you can cover so many more topics, I think there's better ways to explain it. So one of the ways it's been explained to me on my course, which has made sense to me, is kind of approaching problems through a spatial lens, which sounds really odd, and that basically means approaching topics and issues from a perspective that looks at things spatially. So maybe, like in human geography, we tackle a lot of topics that could be considered maybe sociology or criminology, but maybe a geographer would look at kind of spatial patterns in the data, different locations, that kind of thing, whereas a sociologist might look at it from a different perspective. Also, maybe a physical geography example, maybe a geologist and a geographer might study an avalanche, but both could go about it in slightly different ways. So I think a good quote that sums this up comes from the Royal Geographical Society, who say that geography puts the understanding of social and physical processes within the context of place, recognising the great differences in cultures, political systems, economies, landscapes and environments across the world, and exploring the links between them. So you might be wondering how geography actually came about as a subject. Obviously there's multiple different kind of histories of geography within different cultures. However, within the UK, a lot of the recent history of geography can be traced back to kind of map making and different colonial practices across the British Empire. Obviously this is very problematic, and it's something we explore a lot within our course. But basically it means that today geography as a subject is grappling quite a lot with its own history and kind of trying to figure out where it stands today. So unlike maybe some other subjects like English literature or sociology or something, it has much less of kind of a literary canon. But some academics have kind of outlined how this could be viewed as maybe a strength and something good about the subject, because it kind of leaves the discipline open to necessary change, which basically means you can make what you like from the course, and it means that geography is constantly changing and evolving. Basically, in conclusion, if you were kind of confused about what geography is, whether it's a science, does it count as STEM, is it a social science, basically everyone's kind of confused about what geography is. One academic, David Thomas, even said that the discipline itself can seem systematically and regularly confused about what it does, why it does it, and what the relationship is to both other disciplines and the world beyond. And this is something we look at a lot in our course, but basically, very much geography can kind of be what you make of it. Here is a little summary from the Royal Geographical Society that kind of encapsulates some of the things that you can kind of expect to learn about within a geography degree. So this kind of breadth was super appealing to me as kind of an A-level student who didn't really know what I wanted to do or what I wanted to study. I kind of enjoyed both the humanities and the sciences, but I didn't really want to sacrifice either of these. So if that kind of sounds familiar to you, maybe consider a geography degree, because I kind of got to keep both and I quite like that. So obviously, as you probably know, geography is kind of divided into physical geography and human geography. So physical geography is kind of more about understanding dynamics and landscapes and environments, whereas human geography is more linked to kind of cultures, societies and economies. There's also environmental geography, which kind of sits in the middle, but I can discuss that in more depth later. But so one thing I'd recommend looking at when applying to different universities to study geography is whether the course does both human and physical geography, or specialises in one straight away. So when I was looking, I really wanted to do a course that did both in its first year, because like I wasn't really sure which I'd prefer to specialise in down the line. At Oxford, we kind of specialise in our second year, so I think it's nice to have a year to kind of find your feet a bit and decide what you really like. But obviously, if you are like set on human geography, or definitely know you want to do physical geography, there's nothing wrong with that either. You might have noticed that some geography courses are kind of labelled as being a Bachelor of Arts, whereas some are down as being a Bachelor of Science. So this can obviously be quite a good indication of whether a course is more kind of human geography or physical geography weighted, but I would be careful with this because it's not always the case. So for example, at Oxford you can specialise in human or physical geography, but it's always a BA, just because traditionally I think all the three-year courses here, all the three-year courses at Oxford I'm pretty sure are BAs, and then the science ones are 4 years, so it's not always an indication. So I would generally recommend looking at the course structure too, and I think that's a useful thing to bear in mind. So I'm going to just chat a little bit about the course structure now and how kind of our geography degree, the Oxford geography degree specifically, is split into different sections. So in our first year, we do what is called prelims, which is kind of our exams that we sit at the end of our third term. So this is split into four key papers. So that is Earth System Processes, which is basically physical geography, human geography, geographical controversies, which I really enjoyed, and is kind of very new and I think something that you really don't do at school, and also geographical techniques, which is more about like how to conduct field work, kind of ethical issues, that kind of thing. And yeah, these are examined mostly through exams at the end of the year, but also a few bits of coursework like fieldwork reports, maybe an essay, that kind of thing. So basically our first year is very broad and I think gives us a good kind of foundational knowledge of geography. Then in our second year, we can go on to specialise in kind of either human or physical, or you can stick with both if you want to. So in our second year, we have to choose two of three core modules. The three options we get are Earth System Dynamics, which again is basically physical geography, human geography and environmental geography. And environmental geography basically sits in between the two and is kind of just a cross section between human and physical geography. So I chose environmental geography and physical geography, and most people tend to opt to do environmental geography because it's a good kind of bridge between the two and then one of the other ones, but again, you definitely don't have to do that. So yeah, I think this is where we really get to specialise more what we're interested in. But as well as this, we do all have to study another core module called Geographical Thought, which is a bit weird and quite new, but it's basically kind of philosophy of geography, which I didn't even realise we studied, but it's quite interesting and definitely very different to anything I've done before. On top of this, we get to choose three optional modules. So these cover a really, really wide variety of topics, and you can find most of these on the Oxford Geography website. Obviously, these are quite subject to change depending on kind of what lectures are away, that kind of thing. But generally, most of them stay broadly the same. So for example, so far I've done a geographic data science module, which was kind of coding and using GIS, which you don't have to do. And next term I start environmental governance in Central Asia, which I'm really excited about, and I think that should be interesting. But there are so many other options. They span across both like physical geography, human geography, environmental geography. So yeah, we get to choose three of them, which I think is really cool. And all of these bits of work we do in second and third year are kind of part of our final honour scores, which is kind of what our final degree classification is based on. So this is once again examined mostly through exams, and this, we don't sit any in our second year, these all happen at the end of our third year. But there's also quite a lot of coursework, especially compared to some other subjects. So we do our fieldwork report, our dissertation, obviously, which is a really big project and does count towards a lot of our degree, and a couple of extended essays as well. In this next section, I kind of wanted to talk you through kind of a standard week in my life, maybe studying geography. And my day-to-day studying geography can look quite different just depending on what I have on in a day. So I thought I'd give you more of an outline of a few things I do in a week, because I think that's a bit more representative. So with lectures, we have, I'd say, anywhere between like 3 to maybe 10 hours of lectures in a week. I'd say this kind of decreases as your degree goes on and it kind of shifts more to independent work. We have a tutorial every week, which is kind of a session with a tutor and then two or three of us. So that's a lot more small group work. And for each tutorial, we have to write an essay. So we'd usually have one tutorial a week, maybe two. And also, we maybe would also have a class in a week, which is where it's everyone who studies geography in our college. So at Jesus, that is seven of us and a tutor. So those would be the main things I have on most weeks. And then on top of this, I might have some other meetings or practical sessions. So maybe a meeting with my dissertation supervisor, maybe a coding practical session, maybe some field work. So there's a few extra bits that can come on top of that. But I would say the majority of the work we do is kind of independent study. The general advice, I think, is to treat it like the amount of hours you do for a 9-to-5. Obviously, this allows quite a lot of time to do whatever extracurricular activities, socializing, whatever you want to do outside of those hours. So obviously, one of the big benefits of studying geography that I wanted to talk about is field trips. So this is something you get in geography that you really don't get in that many other subjects, so I wanted to just chat about it for a bit. In our first year, we have a few smaller trips, so we go to Portland for about 2 nights right at the start of the year, and that's mostly just to get to know everyone. And then we also have a couple of day trips to different places as well later in the year, but the main trip we get is in our second year, and this is kind of when we've specialized a bit more into human or physical or environmental geography. So the options at the moment, which they could change, but is a physical geography trip to Tenerife, which is one I went on, or you can do a human or environmental geography trip to Amsterdam or Utrecht. Obviously you can also go to whichever. I know people who do human geography that came to Tenerife, even though it's a more physical geography trip, so it is quite flexible. And I think these are really cool because they're a really good opportunity to get to know people from your course, which a lot of subjects don't get, and it's also not a massive year. There's about 80 people across the university, which I think is not huge. Also, the trips are funded by the university, which is really nice, so you don't have to worry about paying for it or anything. And I think it's just really good to have an opportunity to get like actually hands-on in the field and to get practice kind of measuring data, working as a group, analysing data, all that kind of thing, and then you write a fieldwork report about it afterwards. And this was like a highlight of my second year. I really, really enjoyed our Tenerife trip, and yeah, definitely one of the big benefits of doing geography. So I know a lot of you watching probably are thinking, this sounds great, but can I actually get a job afterwards? So obviously, I can't really speak from experience because I've not graduated yet, but I can kind of just chat to you about some of the skills you gain from a geography degree and like some of the careers I know of and are kind of advertised to us that people can go into. So I think one of the benefits of geography is that it really isn't too specialised, and obviously in life a lot of jobs aren't that specialised, so it is kind of nice to have more of like a rounded and holistic approach, and I think that's really beneficial. And you also gain a lot of more general skills like critical thinking and like how to deal with moral and ethical issues in fieldwork, teamwork, communication and problem solving, that kind of thing, as well as some more specialised skills that are more kind of subject specific to geography. So like I talked about earlier, thinking spatially, also kind of how to make maps, you can choose to do that kind of thing, as well as field data collection and also some types of coding. So like I said earlier, I do JS, which is Geographic Information Systems, which is kind of a type of computer software that we can use and choose to learn how to use. So obviously this can lead to a lot of very different careers. A lot of people go on to do more qualifications, maybe like a law conversion, a master's degree, PhD, PGCE to become a teacher, but also a lot of like professional jobs like business, marketing, town planning, construction, human resources, journalism. There's loads of different things you can go into, and it's quite nice to be able to keep your options more open, I think. So as we come to the end of the video, I just wanted to really emphasise that the main reason you should want to study geography is just because you enjoy it. So yeah, you need to enjoy the subjects you want to study at university, so definitely enjoyment should be high up on the list of reasons to choose why you want to study geography. And yeah, I hope you found this video useful, and thank you for watching.